I'm out here performing what I'm going to call my ultimate range test. This testing method will work with any bike, and you do not have to run the electric bike all the way down to zero or a low battery percentage. You can do a very quick estimate of what your range will be under a certain condition by just looking at the current that the motor is outputting at a certain speed, and I'll show you how to do the calculations later. Calculating range is easy and quick. You take your battery capacity times the speed divided by the current. For example, my XP 3.0 long range has a 14 amp hour battery. At 29 miles per hour on flat concrete, I'm seeing a current of 17 amps on my display. So 14 amp hours times 29 miles per hour divided by 17 amps gives me a 24 mile range for these conditions. I'm going to do a test on asphalt at 7, 10, 15, and 20 miles an hour. Then I'm going to repeat it on a smooth gravel road up there. So let's get started. I'm gonna do throttle only first. Okay, at 7 miles an hour, I'm seeing a fairly consistent 1 amp draw. Now let's go to 10 miles an hour. At 10 miles an hour, seeing 2 amps, 4 to 5 amps to maintain 15 miles an hour. For 20 miles an hour, I'm seeing 6 to 7 amps required. Now I'm going to do the same test but with pedal assist, and I'm going to try to do the minimum amount of pedal assist required to engage the motor. Pedal assist 1 is giving me 7.4 miles an hour with minimal pedaling and a steady 1 amp. Pedal assist 2 is giving me 11.3 miles per hour and a very consistent 2 amps. Pedal assist 3, I'm seeing 16 miles an hour and I would say about 4 amps. Pedal assist 4 is giving me 23 miles an hour, solid 8 amps. Pedal assist 5, I'm getting 29 miles an hour, 18 amps. Let's call it 17. So now we're up here on this gravel road. It's very level. The gravel's not too deep. Let's see what difference it makes. I'm gonna start with throttle only testing. 7 miles an hour, seeing about 1.5 amps. Let's go to 10. At 10 miles an hour, I'm seeing a steady 3 amps. At 15 miles an hour, I'm seeing 5 amps. Let's go to 20. Let's go to max throttle. So on the gravel, max throttle is only giving me 19.3 miles an hour. 7 to 8 amps, it looks like. So let's call it 7.5. So ghost pedaling on pedal assist 1, which gets you about 7.2 miles an hour. I'm seeing between 1 and 2 amps. Pedal assist 2 on gravel, 10.9 miles an hour, 3 amps. Pedal assist 3 on gravel, 15.5 miles an hour, 5 amps. Pedal assist 4, 10 amps, 22 miles an hour. Pedal assist 5 on gravel, 27 miles an hour, 19 amps.
Comparing the range between gravel and concrete, there's a pretty clear difference, and it's in the direction that we expected to see a difference. Gravel produces a lower range because of the greater rolling resistance. One interesting thing is that Lectric claims a 25 mile range for pedal assist 5 on a flat surface. So that's what I got on concrete. I did run pedal assist 5 in a different direction. I ran that north to south instead of south to north like the other levels. Things like slope and wind can have an effect. The slope apparently when I ran pedal assist 5 is closer to what Lectric's test was. The nice thing about this method is that you can pick any condition you want, you know, windy conditions, no wind conditions, hot, cold, rough surface, smooth surface, and get an estimate of what the range would be for your bike on that type of surface in those conditions. If you have any questions on how to carry out this type of testing, please leave a comment below and I'll be glad to provide more detail. If you found this information useful, hit that like button so more people are exposed to the video, and subscribe to be notified of future content.